Now, it is going on to the next member of the Al-Azm family. Please welcome Iman Al-Azm, who will be speaking about Recollections.
Many of you are here today to honor Sadiq, the thinker, the public intellectual. Others are here in the memory of a friend. I'm here to honor him as my father. I would like to start by saying that Sadiq lived his life as he saw fit. He described his life's journey as prolific, full, and rich, a journey which I enjoyed tremendously, a life with no regrets. In other words, he did it his way, just like the Frank Sinatra song, and connects to what I think was singing earlier. Sadiq's life can be divided into three stages: the 60s and 70s in Beirut, the 80s and 90s in Damascus, and the early years of the 21st century, where he was shuttling back and forth between Damascus and the rest of the world, and his later years in exile. Of course, as his son, I have accompanied him on his journey. And I would like to tell you a little bit about some of my memories of him. I grew up in Beirut and Damascus, where most of Sadiq's important and influential books were written. I was raised in a very cultured and academic home surrounded by books and art. A home vibrant with ideas, fueled by my parents' love for culture and knowledge. My brother and I were both exposed to the theater and ballet at an early age, especially on our trips to Europe. And it was this early exposure to the arts and the theater that eventually led me to study cinema. In terms of Beirut years, a lot stands out. This is Sadiq there for you. As a child, I hated school. Okay? Life was unbearable because I had two teachers at home, my mother Faust and Sadiq, who made sure that I did my homework. But it was through them that I learned the benefits of hard work, and I'm grateful for that. And as I write these words, the images of Sadiq that pop up in my mind are: see the man with the glasses and the mustache? That's what I remember, and I remember him smoking cigars. I don't know, I was maybe 3 or 4 years old. I also remember Sadiq playing Monopoly with me and my brother, and our trips to the airport to watch the planes take off and land, and of course the usual Sunday visit to grandparents. That's the guy in the middle there, Sadiq, me and my brother. And of course, visiting grandparents, I had to eat kibbeh lebaniye and risotto food and the terrible, terrible rice pudding. So, let's move to Damascus. Damascus, I was going through a rebellious stage. However, I started to appreciate my parents' conversations in the evenings. I remember the conversations my dad used to have with my mother about Sadiq's books. I remember him referring to her and asking her about references to Arabic and English literature. When it came to Salman Rushdie, he was referring to my mom because of her knowledge with the novel. So this is something I remember very much in Damascus. I also remember copying Sadiq's books by hand. He would write them, give them to me for extra money, and to copy them by hand, and then I took the nice copies and I gave them to my mother to edit. But I remember going through all of those books. Of course, as a teenager, hating school, Pink Floyd, Brick in the Wall was my song. But imagine my surprise when I realized that Sadiq actually enjoyed Pink Floyd and Iron Maiden. And to me, my revenge was when he realized one day that I loved listening to Nazim Ghazali. He never imagined something like this in his house. At school in Damascus, I had logic and philosophy, and I was terrible at it. But my teacher was Sadiq's examples and he demonstrated the benefits of logic and how you apply it, especially in critical thinking. And I think this is a skill that I got from him, which has benefited me today. Later on, still connected to the master's years, I decided to study cinema after seeing Peter Greenaway's The Cook That Thief, His Wife and Her Lover. I told my dad, go see the film because it's a really great film. He didn't like it. However, he supported my passion without a question. When I needed money to make films, he was ready to pay. I think this is a clear indication of his love for culture and cinema. In his exile years, whenever his trips brought him to Europe, we would meet and enjoy a father-son coffee or a meal together. In 2016, August 2016, I conducted an interview with my dad. It was a personal interview. It's, I think, one of the last he gave. And somehow I decided I want to get to know the man who's not my father. I want to get to know the man and the man behind the books. So we sat down and we had about a four-hour open and frank interview, and I was very, very happy that I had decided to do it then. Finally, I am proud to announce today that the Sadiq Jalal Al-Azm Foundation website is up and running. My brother and I have founded a foundation in my father's honor, where we would like to spread Sadiq's intellectual and cultural legacy and promote his ideals of and values of humanism, rationalism, secularism, and tolerance. The foundation is committed to supporting and promoting scholarly work, discussions, publications, and other activities related to Sadiq's intellectual and cultural legacy. The website will also include an Arabic version with a specific purpose of reaching. Next slide, please. Sorry. Where was I? For reaching an Arabic version for reaching the Arab youth and thinkers about Sadiq's ideas and writing for the next generation. The next slide, please. Thank you very much. For